in the fleshing out of any national security court that would supervise, monitor, et cetera, a preventive detention scheme. And I point out that the Obama filing in the court, which I found very surprising, I'll leave it at that, having been an ardent supporter of Mr. Obama all last year, they said, this is just for Guantanamo. We're currently going through a completely, a separate process to decide what we're going to do in futuro. And this is, and even this process, they said, is evolving, but here's where we are now. But here are the questions. Who runs this? The military runs this? Does that mean these people are in military facilities? The way you are treated in military, or the things you can do with people in military proceedings, a lot different than you can do when they're in a civilian prison. Can they be interrogated? Once they're put into preventive detention, can they be interrogated by the military or by the CIA? I don't know. We all are, I'm sure, current with the recent revelations of what some of the CIA interrogations were like, and we're hopeful that will not happen in the future. But nonetheless, I think one of Jack's pieces said, well, listen, those Article III judges, they will periodically look it over. How are they going to be in a position to know whether these guys who were not put in because, as I understand it, they were dangerous in your proposal, although that's a real question, is there a dangerousness component to deciding, prediction, to deciding whether somebody goes into the process, or is it simply that they aided in some, as the Obama filing said, some substantial way the Al-Qaeda or Taliban or some other organization in the past?